Welcome back to our Proxmox series. Today I'll show you step by step how you can install Proxmox on your system, transforming it into a powerful virtualization environment. Let's get started. Before we dive into the installation, let's ensure you have everything you need. All you really need is a USB flash drive. It may sound a bit surprising, but an older USB 2 flash drive will probably serve you better than a newer one. And it should have at least a few gigabytes of capacity, something like 8 will do. First things first, head over to the Proxmox website. Here you will find the download section. For this guide, we are focusing on the Proxmox VE or virtual environment. Click download on the Proxmox VE ISO image to start the download. A little hint here, the torrent download will be much faster. With the ISO downloaded, it's time to prepare our USB drive. Download Balena Etcher or any other similar tool for that matter from its official website and install it. Open Balena Etcher, select the Proxmox ISO file, then your USB drive, and finally click flash. It will take a few minutes, but once it's done, eject the USB drive and you're ready for the next step. Insert the drive into your computer of choice and power it up. If you remember my last video about choosing the device for your Proxmox, I'll show you this tutorial on the Intel NUC device. First things first, after powering the device up, jump to the BIOS. For NUC devices, it's the F2 shortcut. But for other devices, it might be other function keys like F8, F10, F11, F12, or the delete key. It will probably be shown on the boot screen. I like to set up a few things here. I'll turn off the onboard Wi-Fi, as I know I won't be using it on the Proxmox host. I'll also set it to power on after a power failure, simply because if there's a power outage, I want this server to come back online as soon as the power is back. And last thing, I'll disable secure boot, as it often causes issues with operating systems. Proxmox in the latest version should have secure boot implemented, but I guess I'm not really used to it by now. Save and exit the BIOS. Restart the system, and I'll show you what kind of errors you might encounter if you used newer USB 3 devices as your installation medium. I'm not really sure what causes this. Ventoy already has some kind of fix for this, but it is yet to be officially released. And if you burn the Proxmox ISO directly to the USB drive, you might have a hard time launching the installation process. Who knows, maybe it's already fixed by the time you're watching this video, but I can't be sure right now. Be on the safe side and just use an older USB drive. Save yourself some trouble. If everything goes according to the plan, you should soon encounter a screen identical to this one. You will be greeted with the license agreement. Just hit I agree. On the next screen, choose your target hard disk. As I have only one here, this isn't much of a choice. In the options menu, you can set up some more advanced settings like file system and so on. For starters, you'll be fine with either X4 or ZFS. Hit next. Choose your country, time zone, and keyboard layout. On the next screen, create your root password and fill in an email address where you would like to receive admin notifications. And next. Here, choose the host name for the device. I'll put in waterdeep.home.lan. I reserved IP address 10.0.0.1.2.3 for this one. Set up your gateway address and DNS server address. These settings are correct for me. Next, and install. After the installation process is done, you will see this recap screen. The key information here is that you will find a web interface to Proxmox on port 8006. So reboot the device, remove the installation USB from your computer, and wait a little while until you see this screen. This almost blank screen indicates that the Proxmox is up and running, and you can access its web interface on the IP address on port 8006. So I'll hop to my main computer, fill out the URL in my browser, accept these security risks as we do not have proper certificates on our local network, and here we are. You'll be greeted by the Proxmox login screen. The username is root and the password you created in the installation process. Login. The first thing you'll see will be this nagging message that you do not have a valid paid subscription. Just hit OK and don't worry about it. You don't need to pay any money to use Proxmox and it won't be limited in any way. And that's it. You've successfully installed Proxmox. You can see servers in the left menu. Right now, there's only one named Waterdeep. That's what I named the device in the installation. There are no virtual machines here, no legacy containers, but don't worry, we'll get to that soon enough. In the summary section, you can find some basic information about your device, like status, CPU memory, and storage resources usage, and more. Again, we'll get to everything in the following videos. From here, the real fun begins. If you found this guide helpful, please give us a thumbs up, subscribe for more tutorials, and drop any questions or experiences you have in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Now continue to our next episode, where I'll explain to you the whole Proxmox interface, followed by a few must-do things you should do right after you install Proxmox.